Okay. That depends on quite a lot of things, but we try to keep it as simple as possible. So when we are starting the garden season, it usually starts in and around March, February, is when we start to actually sow our vegetables. So we're just referring here to vegetables at the moment, nothing else, okay? So for example, if you see over here to my right, you'll see the potatoes, they would have been planted in March and they're coming up beautifully now, okay? If we look at the leeks here, again to my right, they would have been sown in March, April. And with something like leeks, you know, you'd associate that with the wintertime leek and potato soup, for example, the leek and potatoes that are growing right alongside each other. That with the leeks, you will have them right throughout the wintertime into next spring, in fact, before they bolt. So what I'm trying to say, I guess, is that, you know, people associate gardening with July, or rather the summertime, but it doesn't have to stop. It doesn't have to stop now. So it's now June, okay? So you can keep sowing and growing. So you don't need to stop. When people start in March, they're full of enthusiasm, getting the plants sown, getting them out into beds. But at this time of year, for example, we're now towards the middle end of June, is that you can keep sowing if you still have room in your beds for lettuce, for spinach, for chard, for beetroot, for Florence fennel, to mention but a few, okay? And those plants that you sow now, or crops that you sow now, they'll keep you going right up until October, okay? So all the cabbage family, cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, these are fantastic plants because they're, in Ireland in particular, because they are really, really hardy. And you will have all of those right into next spring from your spring sowings the previous year. So we'll say, for example, a good example is, I guess, purple sprout and broccoli, which is sown in April and you start harvesting the following March. So when you think, oh, I've nothing in the garden, blah, 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 then you find, oh, our purple sprouting broccoli, isn't how wonderful, and it tastes like asparagus, it's absolutely gorgeous. So the cabbage family are a wonderful family of plants to actually tide you over through the summer, through the autumn, through the winter, and right into next spring, in fact. So that's one aspect of keeping the garden going. It's about sowing little and often, particularly of things, salad crops such as your lettuce, such as your rocket, your mitsuna, your coriander. If you have a polytunnel, of course, that's absolutely fantastic, because that polytunnel will bridge the gap. What we normally refer to as gardeners is the hungry gap, because May is the time when you actually have very little, because all of these crops such as your leeks, your cabbages, etc., they'll be finished. So that's where your polytunnel comes in, because you can start sowing for your polytunnel in February. So say, for example, carrots, mange two peas, lettuce, for example, just to mention three, and they will come in to harvest in May, so that your polytunnel bridges that gap between outdoor production or outdoor growing and gardening and what you have indoors. But that can only happen if you have a polytunnel or a glass house, for example. But, you know, in reality, if you've sown onions, for example, or planted onion bulbs, you'll harvest them in August, main crop onions. You'll dry them, you'll store them, okay? And then that means once you dry and store them, you will have those onions right up until the following May before they start to sprout. Similarly with potatoes, your main crop potatoes, earlies do not store, main crops do. You can store your main crop potatoes to keep you going right throughout the winter time, right into the following spring before they start to sprout again. And then outdoors, as I said before, right throughout the winter time, You can leave your brassicas outside, your cabbage plants, cabbage family plants, I should say, and they will just keep giving and giving and giving. We'll say Brussels sprouts at Christmas time, you know, for your traditional Christmas dinner. So that's kind of just a kind of an overview, if you like, of planning a year's harvest. It's quite complicated, but it's just to give you a sort of an idea that we don't stop sowing after March. You can keep going March, April, May, June, July, August, okay? And then pretty much it stops then until you start again the following March. We were talking a bit outside about planning a year's harvest, and we mentioned that the best time to start is actually in March. Okay, so normally here in the Organic Centre and here in Leitrim, we sow pretty much everything in trays first to transplant out later on when the weather improves. So things that you can start off in trays, if you're doing this yourself, are the following. And it's just a sample of some of the stuff that you can get going with in March. So lettuce, rocket. Now rocket, we have all the other oriental greens such as mitsuna, giant green mustard. So all of those can be sown in March. And they quite like the cooler end of the season as opposed to later on when they tend to bolt or run to seed. Okay. Your summer cabbages can be sown in March. Okay, so cabbages have three different harvesting periods. We have spring cabbage, which is actually sown in August, to harvest in spring, the following spring. We have summer cabbage, which is to harvest in summer, autumn and winter cabbage. So depending on the variety, just always check on the back of the packet what the variety actually is and when it actually is coming in to harvest, okay? And plan around that. Then you have broccoli, which is technically the proper word for broccoli, it's actually calories, okay? Calories is what you get in the shops, alright? But we call it broccoli because that's what people are familiar with. If you want to grow cauliflower, now is the March time to sow. It can actually be staggered as well, but just for the sake of argument, just for what you're starting off with. Spinach, chard, beetroot, they can all be sown at this time of year in March. Fantastic, easy to grow crops. If you like coriander, again, even though we associate it with Indian food, it actually prefers the cooler end of the growing season as opposed to the warmer end of the growing season. If you like dill, you can sow that. Again, always only sow what you're actually going to eat and that you actually like. Alright? If you have a tunnel or a glass house, now is the time to get your tomato seeds in, and your peppers, and your chilies. And in fact, with those, if you wish, if you have the facilities, you can get them started in February. But if you don't, wait until March, okay? And then just other things I thought of that you can sow in March are scallions, parsley, and celery, all right? Now, all of these things, if you don't sow them in March, with the exception of tomatoes, peppers and chilies, which you have to, your outer window is March for sowing those because they're very ongoing season. All of this can be done in April as well. It doesn't have to be done in March, but what I'm saying to you is this is what is possible and it's just a sample of stuff that you can get going with in March if you have the space and if you have the seed trays and if you have the facilities to do it. What has to be done in March, if at all possible, is to plant out your early potatoes. So you need to have your beds ready to go for early potatoes and for your onion sets as well, okay? Onions are best grown from sets in terms of it's the easiest way to do it, but you just have to watch out for, with the onion sets, are birds because they'll pick them out of the beds because they think it's nesting material for their nests because they see the little brown papery shoots, if you like, sticking up from above the soil. Okay, so that's quite a lot to be getting on with in March for starters. And as I said, you can, with the exception of tomatoes, peppers, and chilies,
you can start all those sowings off in April as well. So I would say April as before, and then additional things that you can sow are kale, okay, because kale is going to keep going right throughout the winter, right into the following spring of the following year, all right? So you can sow these a wee bit later because they're going to be in the ground for the best part of the year. Purple sprouting broccoli, which I mentioned while you were out in the garden earlier. Swede, we call turnip in Ireland, but it's actually technically it's Swede. Kohlrabi, which is a really quick turnaround member of the cabbage family, and it's quite delicious. It's kind of like a cross between a radish and a turnip. It's really nice, and it grows within about 6 weeks. You're ready to harvest at the height of the growing season. And then baby turnip, okay, which is not a hugely popular vegetable in Ireland, but would be quite popular, particularly in Britain, much more so than it is here for our Swedes, which we call turnips. Okay, so if the weather is good enough and if the soil has dried out enough, you can start some direct sowing outside, okay? So, for example, you can sow radish outside directly in the ground, you can sow carrots, you can sow parsnips. I tend to leave sowing carrots until about June because of a pest called carrot root fly. The first generation of the carrot root fly hits in May, okay? So if you want to avoid that, technically you can start sowing in April, but I prefer myself personally to wait until about June, okay? And April is the main time to plant main crop potatoes. Okay, it's the main time to plant main crop potatoes. Okay, so you wait until April